Animal migration is a long-distance movement of individual animals, usually on a seasonal basis. It is found in all major animal groups, including birds, mammals, fishes, reptiles, and insects. The trigger for the migration may be local climate, local availability of food, the season of the year, or for mating reasons. Some of these animals even cross thousands of miles during their long migration. But which animal travels the most on his journey? Recent studies have shown that the Arctic tern travels an average annual round trip length of about 71,000 km for birds nesting in Iceland and Greenland, and about 90,000 km for birds nesting in the Netherlands. Since the birds often live 30 years or more, the researchers estimated that over its lifetime, an Arctic tern migrates about 2.4 million km, equal to 3 trips to the moon and back. Until recently, only larger birds could be followed using tracking devices because the gadgets were too big and heavy to attach to small birds. But a team used a tiny tracker which weighs just 1.4 grams, light enough for an Arctic tern to carry on a band around its leg. The Arctic tern flies as well as glides through the air. It nests once every 1 to 3 years, depending on its mating cycle. After it has finished nesting, it takes to the sky for another long southern migration. They are medium-sized birds with a length of 28 to 39 cm and a wingspan of 65 to 75 cm, and it weighs just about 100 grams. The Arctic terns are long-lived birds with many reaching 15 to 30 years of age. They eat mainly fish and small marine invertebrates. The species is abundant, with an estimated of 1 million individuals. Like all migratory animals, the birds travel to take advantage of food that is available in particular seasons. So why do they take such a long route? The answer is surprisingly simple. It is thought the birds are simply following huge spiraling wind patterns into the atmosphere, and so avoid flying into the wind. A 2013 tracking study of half a dozen Arctic terns breeding in the Netherlands showed an average annual migration of approximately 90,000 km. On their way south, these birds roughly follow the coastline of Europe and Africa. Having rounded the southern tip of Africa, they then turn the east, some flying approximately halfway to Australia before again turning south to eventually reach Wilkes Land in the northeastern Antarctica. One flew along the entire south coast of Australia, passing between Australia and Tasmania, having reached the Melbourne area. Once he got back in Netherlands, the bird had journeyed approximately 91,000 km, the longest migration yet recorded for any animal. Breeding begins around the third or fourth year. Arctic terns mate for life and in most cases return to the same colony each year. Both sexes agree on a site for a nest and both will defend the site. During this time, the male continues to feed the female. Mating occurs shortly after this. Breeding takes place in colonies on coasts, islands, and occasionally inland on the tundra near water. It often forms mixed flocks with the common tern. It lays from 1 to 3 eggs. And is one of the most aggressive terns, fiercely defensive of his nest and young babies. It will attack humans and large predators, usually striking the top or back of the head. Although it's too small to cause serious injury to an animal of human size, it is still capable of drawing blood and is capable of repelling many raptorial birds, polar bears, and smaller mammalian predators such as foxes and cats. Arctic terns are considered threatened or a species of concern in certain states. Exploitation continues in western Greenland, where the population of the species has been reduced greatly since 1950. BirdLife International has considered the species to be at lower risk since 1988, believing that there are approximately 1 million individuals around the world. If you enjoyed this video, consider subscribing to find out more interesting topics, and as always, thanks for watching!